basically even the Christians are the ones doing the worst things. And when they cheat the people, they steal from the treasury, and then they bring it to church, they bring that, they do some philanthropy work. So I want to know what's God's reaction to that. And if God is going to punish them, will the church get back on it?
His question is that, you know, we have many Christians in offices, government offices, you know, they cheat people and then they bring the money, they pay tithes in the Church of God, they also contribute, even some even buy things, you know, in the house of God that this one is presented to God. And his question is that if God is punishing them, the Church of God be part of it. Any contribution?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That question, actually, people don't cheat in the offices to make good ends meet. You know, as we are bringing that kind of money to the church is not aware that the money will be stolen from you. So as you are bringing it, church is not aware, and church is not going to find out from you if the money that because within you, you're supposed to have that clear conscience within you that this money you are bringing to the church is not a clean money. So if you are bringing the money to the church and you are paying your tithe, church is not aware of the fact that you stole the money. I don't think church will be part of the punishment of that money. It is you that stole the money that you face that punishment square. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name.
Thank you, sir. Any other contribution?
The giving should be based on what? the purpose of your heart. So me, I'm working in Federal Ministry of Technology. And when they said I should write a check of 50 million, I wrote a check of 500 million, I made the money, and I said, oh, Pastor, all what you need for church, I bought it, 2 million naira. Pastor was all out here, but the issue is with you and your God. Even the offering you gave now, the envelope you gave unto you, is with you and you. That was why the Sunday scripture was saying you need to have a relationship with God. To have a what? You must have it. If you don't have a relationship with God, you can do anything to make money. Anything. That was why so many people, when they are making their money, they don't care what happened. If you are the director in the pension department, and you took people's pensions money, put in their account to make money, I don't expect you to be a child of God to do such. So, relationship with God must be first. When it's come to giving in the church, even if that is the reason when many of us don't pay tithe, you didn't have a relationship with God. When you refuse to pay your tithe, you didn't have it with God. I've never been begging people to pay offering. I don't know how to carry people to pay offering. That was why in this place we give you envelope, either you pay or you don't pay, it's with you and your what? Your God. When it comes to the work of God, my wife knows, my quote is that God's work done in God's way will never serve God as sister. So it is you that God will never change. God will have ready-made people prepared for his work. So when it's come to giving in the church, check your hearts. Many of us, we have never given our hearts to God. That was why when we check offering at times, we see 3D offerings. You too, you know now that when it's come to tithe, you don't pay it regularly. When it's not off, you know, even though that was the reason why when you get to your shop, you try to manipulate this. You have not really had the relationship with God. And that person with that said, do you have a relationship with God? Ask him very well. God does not concern how many times you go to church every year. Praise the Lord. Supposing you are in a place where there is no church. You are in Bangladesh, or India, or Afghanistan. Where there is no church, would you pray to your God? Do you, ask the person again, do you really have relationship with God? Is God your father? So, that one must be settled first. When you settle that one, then you begin to talk about offering. The Lord gave us Jesus in. The place that we read God's Psalm said, God love me what? A cheerful giver. Change your offering. I wouldn't cajole you. I will not push you. And Pastor, tell us, I will tell you what the Bible says. If you refuse to change, it is you that is not changing. God Himself wants you to change. The Lord gave us Jesus in. I will answer that question when I tell you. Yes, so when it's going to, go to some stuff. Yes, sir. Just let me give you 5 more minutes. Yes, sir.
My question is it by picker? For to give a card, like a tithe card, offering card, then someone's name will be written on it, then they will be recording how much. But is it by picker, sir?
Praise the Lord. No, that it's not by picker. But the pastors that are doing it was trying to help the members. You know, Joshua says something in Joshua 24. He said, as for me and my house. But before he got to that place, he told me like that. Look, you guys, I want you to choose. I have placed before you life and death. But I want you to choose. But life for me, Joshua, my wife, and my children, we will serve the Lord. So the pastor on our green card, registering full name, wants you to go to heaven. He wants you to be blessed. It is the duty of the shepherd to make sure the sheep take good pasture. Bible says, he led me to green pasture. The shepherd wants to eat fresh pasture. So he now said, let me create the card. Let me monitor Mr. Tunji. He collected 2,000 naira per month. Let me see that he's paying that tithe. That is the work of a shepherd. But in the New Testament church, what we did is that we wanted to have a relationship with God. If we have with God, praise the Lord. We went somewhere on Friday. I did not need to cajole that woman. We were not praying. He said, Pastor, the Lord ministered to me that she gave me my laptop. She said that she bought it 1,500 pounds. She brought it, said, what? Just some months ago. Pam, market, pam, gaja, gave it to me. And I said, oh. I bought laptop. Somebody bought laptop. See that laptop. Somebody bought it last year. Well, I should have went to that buy it. I mean, it's not running. Somebody send the money, send it to you. You bought
it. I don't know it.
I don't smoke. But I bought it. I never met her. I didn't see her picture once. Now that one's then you take another one. I was just laughing. Laptops. After that, I struggled to have one 2007. Beg. I beg for a month to come and say, Oba Jay, Pondu, these are laptops of 9th generation, 10th generations. They are really machines. And I was wondering. So the woman has a relationship with God. Kushema, Fedefor, and Sorrow. I did not use all the things. I can't take her, I think. If you have that thing with God, to give to God will not be a difficulty. You don't want to give a little bit, Pastor, you don't know what to do. And I was wondering, let me remind myself, So, I want to, those people that gave God want you to go to heaven. It is the duty of the shepherd. So, when you see Pastor gave God, he wants to go to heaven. I'm telling you, if you come to this church, make sure you have a relationship with God. And now I'm telling you, build that relationship with God first. Build it. Somebody called, I told you that one from US. She said, oh, right, you have to the door when I say, I don't know, Saturday, oh, my talk, I don't know. I want to share the Bible study, never any seeing me. I want to share one with you, I'm back. The Bible study that you don't attend, somebody is attending in the US. Now I'm telling you, build your relationship with God first. So that anywhere you find yourself in the world, it is you and your God. Tell the person by your side, you say, God is talking about your grandchild. Tell him. All of us are children. So if you build your own with God, fine. If you take it as a third party down to receive a top friend, come out from brave friend, come out of the not to put the chin chin, I know, or look at the boss, or be number five, I have you no sweet. It's your choice. Because you were saying, I will close my eyes, I will put on the loop, and I will be wrong. But when you have a relationship with God, oh, you are free. Anything that I read to you will be and what? An addition. God will help us with us. We will be taking deeper next week Sunday to the school. I want to encourage you. So the school starts by 8 a.m. So you take stand upon your feet. I hope you are giving something.
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
I want you to pray a particular prayer point for yourself. You know, that's the reason why we are in the church. I want you to tell God, Lord, let it be convenient for me to walk with you. Let it be what? To do what? Let it be what? Say it only now. Get poor on me, long last in the bowing. When it is convenient for you to be the will of God, even at the because of circumstances, you will love to do that way. Let it be convenient for me to work with you. Pray in the name of Jesus. Pray very well. Yes. Let us pray very well. Pray very well. Take a step forward while we are praying.
In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Father Lord, we thank you for this day. We appreciate you for the words we've heard. Father, we pray that it will let it be committed for us to serve you, to walk with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And everywhere we go, we will feel your presence in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We come into this service into your hands, Father Lord. We want you to bless us accordingly in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And at the end of the service, let's have every cause to glorify your name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Continue today's service as we sing from our CSC book, our opening hymn from hymn 46. For today is a Sabbath unto the Lord. Jesus will love to meet on this, the holy day. We gather round the throne on this, the holy day. Thou art our heavenly friend. Our prayers are sent to thee. Look on our spirit, Lord, on this day. Holy day, on this the day of your birth.
What is
this,
Lord? the Lord, oh my soul, and everything that dwells within me. Bless His holy name. I want us to begin to bless His name. We worship God this morning. From the bottom of your heart, worship God, worship God, worship God, worship God. We bless your name, oh Lord. We bless your name. He